Yuri Gagarin invited us all into space.
He paved the way to the stars.
He opened a new chapter in the history of mankind.
It's clear that it was the era of confrontation. The race between the two camps and the Soviet Union was trying to show the world its achievements, technical and political. Until then, only dogs and chimpanzees had been in space. It was necessary to launch a man, to demonstrate that a person could be in orbit for a while and to return alive and safe on Earth.
I was very lucky to be part of the group that designed the Vostok spacecraft. They were not just important engineers and scientists, they were true visionaries.
The cosmonaut was selected from a great number of volunteers, 3,500, I think, all jet pilots. The top 20 passed initial training, then a group of 6 men were selected for the first division, and finally the one, Yuri Gagarin, was chosen to make the first space flight.
It's like dressing a man in a suit and shoving him into a blast furnace, saying, "Don't be afraid, the suit will protect you." But nobody knows for sure if it will actually protect you or not. It's exactly the same thing here. Don't worry, everything will be fine. We just don't know what exactly it'll be. It's up to you to tell us when you return.
It's a known fact. The flight lasted 108 minutes, 9 minutes for the orbit insertion, then a single orbit around the Earth. Compared to modern achievements, it seems, well, big deal. Just one orbit. We now fly for months on the International Space Station. But it was the first time man flew into space, and that's what Gagarin's achievement is about.
He didn't actually get to pilot the spacecraft, although he had all necessary controls to conduct a manual descent and landing. That was in case the automation was out of action. All the people were truly, truly jubilant. In our design studio, we celebrated this joyful event massively.
I went out in the center of Moscow and found it full of crowds, all dancing, singing, laughing. I asked, "What's all the joy about?" Girls ran by saying, "Where have you been all this time? Gagarin returned from space." And only then I realized the scale of what had happened. Until then, it didn't seem extraordinary. It was just work for us.
Gagarin strived to fly again. He was training to pilot one of the first Soyuz spacecraft. He wanted to test that ship, and I think if fate had been different, he would have made many more flights. He was one of those who discovered a whole new world for us, for all of humanity.
He was the exemplary man of that era, the model of his time.
Двигатели выходят.